It had been entirely too long, so today's trip is to Trader Joe's. Hey guys, Kira here from 50 Shades of Mom, tips for all shades of mom life. And I had a small window of time today, so I took the opportunity and I ran over to my favorite Trader Joe's. I had about 30 minutes to shop and I think I did pretty good. I spent $162 inside of that 30 minutes and I think that I managed to score all of my wants and my needs without even going in with a list. So that was pretty impressive to me. So I'm gonna take you down to my counter and I'll show you what I got on this trip to Trader Joe's. Okay, you guys, so here is a quick overview of what I got for $162.54 in Trader Joe's. I think I did really good, and I am super excited to show you guys what I got. So for starters, I picked up this ginger beef sirloin for stir fry. The gentleman who was ringing me up asked me if I had ever tried this, and I said no, this was going to be my first time. He said it comes highly recommended and that he thinks it's absolutely amazing. The woman that was bagging for him said she seconds that, she absolutely loves it. And I said, well, hey, while we're on the topic of meat, can I ask you where the Cabernet pot roast is? Every time I've come here, I've looked for it and you guys never have it. I don't know if it's just a state thing. I used to be able to get it in Carolina. So the woman who was bagging for him went and looked, and she came back and told me that the Cabernet pot roast has been discontinued. So I was super sad about that, especially because every pot roast from Trader Joe's is so delicious. But now that I've discovered like a new meat, maybe this will be a fun replacement. This was not a bad cost. It was $12.99, and I'm anxious to do this because we haven't done a stir fry in a long time. So I'm gonna use this for that. And then I got the organic free-range chicken. This is the boneless, skinless chicken thighs. This is Daryl's absolute favorite, so I picked this up to make some Mississippi chicken, of course. And then I got the Trader Joe's lightly breaded fish sticks. This is the reduced fat kind. You could never tell. They're so delicious. They come up nice and crispy, and it works out perfect for like a lunch on the weekends or even a lunch for the kids for school, because these hold really well in a tin foil and a thermos. So I know the kids will be happy about that. I got the rainbow cauliflower. We love this. I rave about this every single time that I get it. It's so sweet on its own, just being steamed. I highly recommend this if you've never tried it before. We got the handsome cut potato fries. These are the ones that are almost similar to Five Guys. Like, they have the skin still on them, and I love fries like that. So if you've not tried these, I recommend these as well. We pick these up every time that we go. Speaking of staples, here is the mandarin orange chicken and the vegetable fried rice. We actually used to get this all the time. It was getting to the point where I was even buying two bags of the orange chicken and one of the fried rice, but we kind of alternate now. We still do enjoy it, but it's like every other time I'll switch up getting this or something else. They have the beef kind, and we have tons of those egg rolls left over from Super Bowl, those veggie egg rolls. So I thought that would go really good with the vegetable fried rice and the mandarin orange chicken, so I'll put that on the meal plan for a day this week. I got the Trader Joe's gnocchi gorgonzola. This is Jake's favorite. He fell in love with the Sorrentino until I got the gorgonzola, but he's more of a white cheddar cheesy kind of kid. And so as soon as I get this for him, he is usually over the moon. So I think I'm going to surprise him with that one day for lunch next week during like Valentine's Day week. Got the organic super sweet corn. We love this. It is so, so good. I love that. We got the roasted potatoes with peppers and onions. We get this every time as well. Definitely one of our favorites. Got the everything ciabatta rolls. So I've never gotten these before, but you guys know how we feel about our everything bread from Walmart. And then we love Trader Joe's everything but the bagel seasoning, which is what I'm sure that they use on these ciabatta rolls. So I figured I would just throw these in the freezer. It's always good to have something like this for a meal. Got the hash browns. This is such a great price, $1.99, and their hash browns are amazing. So pick those up. And then I also picked up the sliced French brioche bread. This stuff is so decadent, you guys. It's like almost like pound cake. So you see how it has the paper on the side, because it's so buttery and rich that it reminds me of pound cake. But I'm making Monte Cristos for dinner tonight, and I was just going to use regular bread for the French toast until I went to Trader Joe's, and I was like, okay, we're gonna get the French brioche bread and use that for the Monte Cristo. So I'm really excited about that. It sounds so, so yummy. And then I got one of these really long baguettes, which I love. I'm going to cut this in half and then put each half in a bag in the freezer. And then whenever we want to do garlic bread on a pasta night or something, I'll just defrost the baguette. This defrosts perfectly. I use it with a little bit of garlic spread and it's delicious. So picked up one of those. And then here's our little veggie and fruit section. So I got these little Nature's Bounty organic potatoes. I love these. They're the tri-colored ones. So there's white ones, red ones, and purple ones. These are so delicious. I cut them up, toss them with olive oil, salt, and pepper, and roast them in the oven, and they are amazing. So we'll use this for a side dish for dinner next week. And then I picked up some tomatoes. We're out of those tomatoes I got from Costco. So I picked up these Pure Flavor. It's not even like a Trader Joe's brand. So it's Pure Flavor tomatoes, but they like spoke to me. Look how red and beautiful and like delicious that they look all on the vine. I love on the vine tomatoes. Look how beautiful this cilantro is, guys. That is a huge head of cilantro for a dollar. Like, this really impressed me, and it smells so good right through the bag. I got these little air couvert string beans. Jake loves, loves, loves these, and I love that they're all cut up and ready to use. Like, if they're all cleaned, their ends are clean, so that'll save me time for lunches in the morning. So I picked that up. Mason ate his last apple yesterday, and like, he came into me like, I'm out of apples. I'm out of apples. I was literally dying. Like, he melts down with no apples. So I got him a bag of his Honeycrisp apples. And then, you guys, this is bigger than the banana situation, except this I picked up on my own. It has got to be cucumber season. Like, this thing is massive. Like, this is a cucumber for three meals. Have you ever seen a cucumber? Like, what in this? I can't. So I got that. Only need one, clearly. I picked up some rice pudding. Mason really loves this, and I like this as a treat as well. So I picked up that, and then I've never seen this before, but this is Belgian chocolate pudding, and we still have that Oreo Cool Whip in the freezer that we've never used. So I thought maybe some of this chocolate pudding with that Oreo Cool Whip would be a nice treat for the kiddos. So I picked up that. And then I got this string cheese. I thought this was an amazing price. It was only $2.99 for this light string cheese. I don't know how many packages are in here, 12. So there's 12 of these for $2.99. I thought that was a good price, and my kids be tearing up the cheese sticks. So I picked that up. And then I also picked up these. I was going to get two, and then I never went back and grabbed another one. But these are the Italian style salami sticks. So they're perfect for lunch boxes, and I think all of my kids would like these. So I picked that up, and then I picked up this mixed medley of cherry tomatoes. My daughter would probably eat a half a container in a sitting at a time if you let her. So I literally go through a container and half a week. So she's gonna be happy to see that we have these back in the refrigerator. I picked up a mirepoix so that I can make a chicken soup coming up next week. Basically, a mirepoix is just already cut for you celery, onions, and carrots. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe that mirepoix stands for like trifecta or three of one kind or something, because it's supposed to be like that is the trifecta, the carrots, onions, and celery is like the whatever. I don't know. That's what they call it. So that's what I picked up for soup. I got some blackberries. These looked amazing. $5.99 for this container. I picked up this yogurt for my kiddos. It's not their absolute favorite. Normally, if I didn't go to the store in the middle of the week, I would never get them more yogurt. They're already out of what I bought on Sunday. But I figured while I was there, I would just pick this up for them, because seriously, my kids eat a yogurt a day. Like, it is their go-to meal, snack, anything. So that one's the strawberry beetberry. It's the one they like the best. They're not like huge fans of the spinach mango. So hopefully they won't mind those. Got a big thing of raspberries. Had to get my sweet and spicy pecans. These won't even last 2 days, you guys. Like, I don't Sorry, not sorry, but they are so stinking amazing. So pick those up. And then I'm going to scroll something on the screen right now for you guys to see, because I picked up a couple of things that I wasn't going to pick up, but they had a clearance section. I have never seen a reduced price section at Trader Joe's. Like, even if it was something left over from the season, it was still never another price. It has always been that same price. But these are the organic naughty and nice dog treats. I got these for my pups for the Christmas time. Like, this was one of their treats for their stocking, but I think I paid $5 or $6.99 for it during the season. It was $2.99, which I thought was absolutely amazing. And then so were these. These were also $2.99, so I got one for each pup for Valentine's Day. But this is the mint flavor dog treats with the beet powder, so it makes them look red, and they're cute little heart shapes for Valentine's Day, so I thought that was cute. And then these, you guys, were 99 cents. So I don't know, I didn't even check the expiration date. I probably should have done that. April. These will not last until April, but 99 cents, I probably should have bought more. There was a whole end cap of them, but that's such a great deal for these Pop-Tarts. I mean, it's even cheaper than a Dollar Tree, for goodness sake. So I picked these up for them. And then this I was gonna buy during the holiday season, but I believe it was $10. Not that $9.99 was a bad price. I mean, I've been paying $4.99 for one box of mix of the Foodstirs organic brand, but when I was there shopping Christmas time, I already had a full cart, so I didn't even think to spend $10 on a thing of cookie mix. But this was marked down to $4.99. $4.99 for three of these. And I just saw Vanessa cook two of them, so I know that they don't make a lot of cookies in each one, but it's still, for $4.99, this is amazing, because I've been making my own snacks for the kids' lunches. So this will last me a couple of weeks. It's the toffee oat cookie mix, the cinnadoodle cookie mix, and then the triple chocolate cookie mix. So the kids will enjoy doing this with me, and it'll also be something that I can use for their lunches, and I don't have to buy snacks. So I thought that was perfect. I did pick up the gummies, X's and O's. We love these. I like the Scandinavian gummies that come Christmas time. They are better than the X's and O's, but these are pretty good too. And so I'm going to use these for Valentine's Day lunches for next week. I did pick up some 21 Seasoning Salute. I forgot this at my mom's over the summertime, and I saw it when I was there this past time, and I was like, oh my goodness, there's my spice. I should throw it back in my bag, and I never did. So for $1.99, I got myself some more seasoning. And then I got the kids their white cheddar puffs. We absolutely love these. They actually chump the original Pirate's Booty, so check those out if you have not. And then I got a little pasta wasted. I guess it's because I don't really buy pasta anymore, and if I do, I would prefer it to be from Trader Joe's. We just love their pasta. It's not even because it's organic or not organic, because I only bought one of the organic kind, but just this specific brand of pasta, the Trader Joe's kind, is so delicious. It's like one of the better pastas that I've ever had. And so if I'm gonna get it, I figured I'll get it from there, and I only go once a month, so this will last just for a while. But I did get the organic penne rigatti. That's my absolute favorite. And then I got the vigils. This is like the corkscrew pasta, so I'll use these for pasta salads and stuff. And then I got orzo. I have a really good parmesan, creamy parmesan garlic orzo that I make as a side dish, and so I need orzo for that, so I picked that up. And then I know these have been there forever, but I went for the tortellini. I've just been in the mood for tortellini Alfredo. But their tortellini, their dry kind, is filled with pesto, and I just know that my family's not going to like that. But then these little mini raviolis filled with cheese were right next to it, and I was like, all right, my family is clearly all about the cheese. So I got this bag of mini raviolis, and I'm going to use that for a meal. And then that was pretty much it for the food, but I did get flowers. I always get flowers at Trader Joe's because flowers make me happy. And I got the white hydrangeas. I was so compelled to get. They had beautiful Gerber daisies and lilies in these pinks and purples and very beautiful Valentine's Day kinds of flowers, but that would be something I would like to receive. But to purchase for myself, to put in my vase, just for that real like farmhouse, just nice fresh flower feel, I like my white hydrangeas and my eucalyptus. Like, if this is not a throwback to my old Trader Joe days, I don't even know what is. But these just look so good together, and I have my good white pitcher, and sometimes I'll throw a few cotton stems in there, and it just looks so pretty. So I pick those up, and then look at this baby. I could have spent $20, but I was like, all right, I'm already buying fresh flowers, so I'm going to stop. But this was $12.99, and they had these all set up in front as like an impulse buy for Valentine's Day gifts, which, to be honest, guys out there, like, this is to me a better purchase than like bringing your wife flowers or roses. Like, these orchids last a really long time, and they're very easy maintenance. You put in 3 ice cubes once a week. That's how you take care of an orchid. That's it. The good cold water melts, and that's all they need is 3 ice cubes worth. So I love that. And if you actually nurse an orchid enough, once these all fall off, they will come back. I've never been able to successfully do it. You have to have patience, like a year or two after the flower falls off, to like keep nursing it until it rebuds again. I don't have patience like that, and I'm late for everything. So usually once the buds fall off, I end up tossing the plant, but this will last 6 months easy. And I just think they're so, so pretty. They had the purple ones and the blue ones and the yellow ones with the pink on the inside. And they were all between $17.99 or $19.99. The only ones that were $12.99 were just the white ones, but it fits in with my decor just fine. So I got those. I have like a zillion of these pots because I always buy the orchids there, but they hold for so long and their price is so good, and I love the way that they look when they're all set up. So that was it for all of that. And then the nice man that I met, that I talked to about the beef sirloin, he was from California, and he said, well, clearly you're not from here. And we started talking. When I said I could get it from Carolina, I said I could get the Cabernet pot roast on Long Island. And so we started talking about our life stories. He came from LA, and he just relocated here also. And so we were just BSing for a while at the register while he was packing my stuff. And as we were leaving, he said, well, let me be one of the first people to welcome you to Texas. And he gave me this bag for free. So look how pretty that is. I have a Trader Joe's one from South Carolina, but this one is so sweet with the cowboy boot. And then it's Texas written there. It's got the little armadillo, and it's got like flowers and fresh veggies in the boot as if you were using it like a Trader Joe's bag. And I thought that was so super cute. And so I will definitely be bringing that with me next time. So that was it, guys, for my $162. Okay, guys, so that was my haul for the month of February. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, make sure to give it a big thumbs up. If you guys are new here, hit that subscribe button. I will post a Trader Joe's haul if I manage to get out there at least once a month. And if you guys are interested in seeing the rest of the groceries that I'm picking up for my family of 5 for the week, stay tuned on Monday. My regular grocery haul and meal plan goes out. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love you all so much, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.